One of these three men is a professional gambler who has never had a losing day in his life. What is your name, please?
My name is Donald Harris.
My name is Donald Harris.
My name is Donald Harris.
Only one of these men is the real Donald Harris. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Gene Rayburn. And appearing all this week on the panel of the daytime version of To Tell the Truth, Sally Ann Howes, Ralph Bellamy, and Dina Merrill. On To Tell the Truth with your host, Bud Collyer.
Thank you very much. Thank you and welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Brought to you this week by the makers of Dristan Nasal Mist, the new decongestant spray for relief from miseries of sinus congestion and colds. Gene, great pleasure to welcome you to our show.
Thank you very much, Bud. I'm very happy to be. I feel very close to this show, even though it's my first time, because 6 or 7 years ago, the predecessor format to the show was tried out in my living room. We had a lot of fun, but it didn't work.
It's working now, fine. And Ralph, you're starring in a Westinghouse Presents, isn't it, in the very near future?
Yes, just completed it on tape.
When does it come up on the air?
This Wednesday, the 20th, from 10 to 11 on CBS.
Hey, we'll be watching, believe me. Now, panel, would you all please open up your envelopes, take out your affidavit cards for the first time, and follow along as I read. I, Donald Harris, am a professional gambler. I play only roulette. I gamble about 4 hours every night, and my winnings average $10 an hour. While I am working, I take regular 5-minute breaks and never drink anything stronger than coffee. The system I use is one I figured out by myself at home when I was still too young to gamble. I am now working out a new system which, if perfected, should double my take. Since I have been gambling professionally, I have never had a losing day at the roulette wheel. Signed, Donald Harris. Well, panel, you've heard these three gentlemen all claiming to be Donald Harris, professional and successfully so, gambler. Let's start this first round of questioning with Ralph Bellamy. Ralph?
Number one, I guess it would be interesting to know where you play roulette professionally.
I play in Reno and Las Vegas.
Las Vegas. Number two, what's the meaning of the term odds back of the line?
I'm sorry, I don't know.
Number three, what is the meaning of odds behind the line, odds back of the line? Number one, would you know?
It's the wrong game.
well, let me see. In 21, number one, I have to assume you know something about other gambling games. Do you stand or draw to 16?
You may never know. Dina.
Goodness. Number two, what nest egg do you start with on your evening or daytime, whatever it is? Is it evening or daytime? Do you do this all day?
Depends. Sometimes day, sometimes night. I start with about $1,000.
Every day? Number three, there is a legal limit outside the United States where one can or cannot gamble. Do you know what that is?
No, I don't.
Do you, number two?
No, I don't. I don't gamble.
Number one?
No, I don't.
You don't know anything about gambling ships, number one?
No.
Number two?
Nothing.
Three? Goodness.
Strictly landlocked lovers they are. Gene.
Number two, if you're a professional gambler, what are the odds of our guessing which one of you is the... I can get a little side bet going here.
About 4-1.
4-1. All right. If I put one chip on one number and it wins, how many chips will they pay me?
Depends on the size of your bet and depends on what number you put it on, whether it's red or black.
Number three, if I put one chip on a number and it wins, how many chips will be returned to me?
35.
Do you agree with that, number one?
Yes, I do.
Now, what is the little ball made of that the croupier spins around? Do you know? Number one? Sorry, number one.
Sometimes it's made of plastic, other times ivory.
Sally Ann.
Number one, what are the gambling laws in New York? The roulette.
I don't believe there are any laws in New York.
Number two. I just want to know if I can do it here, that's all. Number two, is gambling allowed in London?
I don't know about the outside of the United States.
Number three, do you have to have a license to be a professional gambler?
No.
Number one, do you agree with that?
Yes, I do.
Number two, do you agree with that?
Yes, I do.
That's good.
Planning to take up a new career?
I'm not so sure if I do agree.
Well, that's all the time we have, so get your ballots and pencils in hand, and will you mark them right now, please, in the course of voting, and without consultation, vote as you do for number one, number two, or number three. A team of challengers will, of course, receive $250 for every incorrect vote. All set, all ballots marked? Wow, you're fast on this first round. Gene, which one did you select?
Well... Number three doesn't look like a real riverboat man to me. Number two gave me a wrong answer, and I really didn't ask any questions of number one, so I voted for him. It's a gamble.
Sally Ann, which one
is
your choice?
Well, I voted also for number one, and the only reason I can give is I have a little dice here in, underneath the panel, and it came out one.
It did.
The hard way.
Yeah, I'll say it. I'll say that's making a point the hard way. Ralph.
I voted for number one. I have a feeling we didn't ask the right questions. I think the information was mainly on roulette, and it's just on a hunch I'm going with number one.
And Dina.
Well, that makes it unanimous, but
oh,
I'm also
goodness.
With number one. Number three doesn't have that kind of look that a professional gambler ought to have, I don't think. Number two didn't know about the 35-to-1 odds on one chip. I don't know very much about roulette, but number one, somehow.
All right, let's see whether the somehow is right or wrong and find out which of these three gentlemen is the real winning professional gambler. So will the real Donald Harris please stand up?
That's for sure.
At least those dice that you threw, you should give up.
Yeah. Is he of legal age to gamble?
I guess he is. How old are you? 23 years old. Never had a winning night. How about that? Never had a losing night, I mean. Never a losing night. All winning. Boy, I wish I knew what his new system was. It's going to double his stake. Let's find out about these other two gentlemen. Number one, you garnered all the votes. You really fooled them in this bit of gamble. What is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Larry Davis. I'm vice president of Davis Optical Company, and I fit contact lenses.
Good to talk to you. Number two, your real name and what do you do, please?
My name is Rod McKuen. I'm a published poet and a twist singer, currently appearing at the Versailles, Trudy Heller's Versailles in New York.
I'd like to note, for all ages, right here and now, that Rod McKuen wrote and recorded those immortal ballads, You Ought to See Oliver Twist, and another one, I Dig Her Wig. Checking up the score on our own tote board here, we find there were four incorrect. $250 each, gentlemen, that's not a bad evening's fun, you must admit. That's $1,000 to divide among you. And also, of course, you'll receive a gift package of the fine products from the makers of Tristan. We thank you very much, even though you didn't share your secret with us. Good night, and God bless you.